I've been with the district almost 20 years now. I originally started out as a sub and then became a special ed teacher, and I love it. Part of my responsibilities are to support teachers and students, help advocate for students, generally through IEP meetings, working with teachers in the classroom to come up with strategies, to implement things to help students that are struggling. They don't always have a voice. So it's my job to kind of stand in that gap for them and say, you know, this is what they need. They might not be able to say it, but this is what we have to try to do for them.
She always says behavior is communication. That's helpful because we can focus on, okay, well, how can we really help this child move from one place to another and another and another? What makes her great for EBSOLA and Unified in general is her focus has always been, well, what's best for kids and how can we get to the why of what's going on. It really helps to individualize and tailor the instruction and the goals to each student.
Susie is an asset to our school in particular because she has a good understanding of what our students need, their backgrounds, and how to best help them and serve them.
I feel very supported. I think that is one of the benefits of being a big district. You have so many people who've gone through similar situations or have knowledge and experience, so you can go to them and you can collaborate and they can give you strategies and ideas. You have a bigger pool of knowledge and resources. I can't do it by myself. I definitely need other people to help me through things. And so that's why I'm so grateful for all of my coworkers and the other program support teachers, because I lean on them so much.
She's always trying to come up with creative ways to help students while also giving you the valuable information related to special education that you need. And for me, she has been a mentor and someone I can go to as I'm going through my education into special ed, so that I have a good understanding of what I will be doing in the future.
I really feel like she is just a great resource, not just to special ed, being trauma sensitive and informed in practical ways. It's taking it from like context and putting it in the real world.
The one thing I always talk to kids about is we can work together to try to fix something, and tomorrow's a new day. I think people do the best they can with what they have at the time. When we see true growth is when we lean on each other and we're open to trying new things. Every year I feel like I learn something new, primarily from students. I think the one thing that students have taught me is not to take myself so seriously, because I do. It's like, don't sweat the small stuff. I absolutely love the kids at EBSOLA. I think we have some of the most unique students here. They're fun, they're creative, they have wonderful personalities. I feel like they have a lot to give. It's our job to help students who may have a strength in one area and a weakness in another, to have that strength help develop that weakness and kind of use that to help them overcome some things. We have students that come in with a lot of challenges, things that are going on at home that they struggle with, so we really have to meet all of those needs here at EBSOLA. I had an elementary teacher, Mrs. Schneider, who actually was then a principal in the district and just recently retired, and she was somebody, as my fifth grade teacher, that always made me feel like I was the most important person in the world, and I always like looked to her, and even as an adult, had a very close relationship with her, and she just inspired me, and that was one of the reasons why I always wanted to be a teacher. And so to me, like, the way she made me feel, like I was so important, that nothing else mattered, that's the way I want to make kids feel. My passion is to work with kids that are really struggling and help them to overcome, not to leave them like, yes, this is a really tough situation, and I'm so sorry that this is what's going on, but what can we do to help you be successful? So not leaving them stuck and showing them that there's hope and things can get better. It's just us working together to help them overcome that.